present. So my translator have some job. If I say my broken English directly, then he becomes jobless.
It's a great honor for me, and I'm very pleased to be again in Tumkur University. So I would like to first of all greet Professor Pillay and congratulations to the two professors who received the honorary degrees for university.
And
distinguished professors who received the honorary degrees, you actually have been honored this degree from the Tumkur University because you highly deserve it. And I also would like to request you to keep up with your good work for the benefit of the society, and I will have my prayers for your success as well.
Because of that brain, much ability, you see, to carry some sort of method or some sort of work to achieve happy life and reduce suffering. So that's why the last 7 millions of years, I think we human species say much. And at the same time, this marvelous human brain naturally have muscle ability, recall sort of long past experiences. And also since, you see, we develop written language. So that also is an immense help to know past. That also is because of this marvelous sort of brain, we also have a lot of ability about visions, about the future. Now this itself, wonderful, very good. However, the sort of the great memory about past and also great vision about future, that also sometimes is causing more worry, more pain, and more worry, more pain, often, you see, create, frustration. Develop anger. Through that way, violence. Intelligence or brain can be, because of that, can be either both constructive and destructive. I think human history, I think last, perhaps, I think most significant for the human history, maybe last 100,000 years, gradually, you see, our society become more sophisticated as a result, organized, mobilized violence, that's war. Perhaps some small group, monkeys or some animal, those social animals, sometimes they carry little fighting organized way. But the other species of mammals never do as we human being done. And then also you see, our intelligence is trying to prove violence, organized violence is something right. Okay. Individual take violence, murder. We call murder bad. Organized violence. Sometimes we say, even holy war. People who committed killing thousands, hundred thousands, millions of people, sometimes called hero. So our intelligence sometimes really, you see, create a lot of possibly extra problems. So usually I describe 20th century. Oh, marvelous century. In that century, say, lots of development in science and technology. With help of education. However, that century eventually become center of bloodshed. According to some history, 200 million people killed through violence. 21st century, some of these violence is actually symptom of past centuries of Japan, because of a habit or past centuries negligence or mistake. And then, also as you mentioned, you see, many developed countries, like the United States, and also developing countries, like India, although a lot of development, but at the same time, the poverty. But there is a huge gap. Some poor people still there. One time I mentioned in Washington on my public talk, the most richest, powerful nation's capital, Washington, the superb Washington, many poor people. So these people, when you see other people, very rich, all the facilities there, and they themselves, it's a very difficult situation, then automatically frustration turn. That eventually creates violence. So therefore, despite some sort of ability to increase their life, their material life of the poorer section of people, and also despite its ability to reduce this gap, but still sometimes growing. But then meantime, corruption. So, clearly indicate our intelligence, mere sort of, because of the gaps of education, of knowledge, now shows something lacking, not sufficient. Very educated people, very quiet mind. Is it? I think innocent people, villagers, I think less corruption. Even they do not know how to cheat other people. More educated, more intelligent people, oh, they have much more ability to cheat other people. Say very nice things, promise many things, but doing something differently. It's fact. Even religious people, I hope. I myself may not have corrupted. But otherwise, you see, the religious people in various religious traditions, corrupted people there, religion used for exploitation. So, all now, these are events, right? these facts shows us we have to think. More deeply, what is the source of this problem? Now all these negative things, because of sad thing, is ultimately due to lack of moral principle. That's very clear. Other element, I don't think they have certain sort of way to promote these moral ethics. Only we human beings, because of this intelligence. So now, here, education is the key factor. Since among religious people, the corrupted people, there. So religious faith, of course, these people actually not religious people, not faithful about their own religious sort of tradition. If you see people who accept religion, they sincerely sort of follow their tradition, seriously, sincerely, all major tradition talks the value of compassion. And as an individual case, contentment. Many sadhus, many Christians are practitioner. Many Muslims sort of possibly practitioner, and many other. Really, their personal life, very simple. But totally dedicated service to other people. So if people who accept religion implement what they believe sincerely, then all major religious traditions have same potential to produce good human beings, sensible human beings. But why then among the religious believers, a lot of corrupted people there, why? Firstly, you see, they are not. They take religion as a sort of customs or ritual tradition. And frankly speaking, including Buddhist, sometimes we consider religion is something like ceremonially read. Rituals, not much interesting or real practice. I think maybe so. The India I usually discuss how gurus meant. So in this historically our gurus meant, you see, the Indian guru. So the gurus meant here. I think religion becomes something like just simply ceremony or ritual. Even you see, because of without knowing what's the real essence of religion. So that's the reality. Now anyway, so therefore, now we. I think only hope is educate people. This is not a problem. Ultimately, due to lack of moral principle. If you carry moral principle, what benefit to you? That I think is very important to educate. If you carry your life, your professional work, everything according to moral principle. Then you can carry your work transparently. Nothing to hide. Through that way, firstly, you get more self-confidence. You get more inner strength. You can speak honestly, truthfully, frankly. That brings trust from others. Money will not bring trust from others. Plenty of money. But person always takes something because of the hypocritical way. Nobody trusts. Power also will not bring trust from another. Trust only comes if you act honest, truthful, transparently. So, we social element, we need friends. Among human society, friendship is very essential. For physical health also, well, friendly sort of atmosphere is very good. Because, you see, friendship, genuine friendship, you see, brings peace. distrust. You started by distrust people inside some tents. Some scientist state. You from which country? I think previously also I met. This is the thing. Recently I saw an article wrote by one scientist, one American scientist, you see, mentioned people who often tell lies. Much stress, right? So blood pressure also increase. Tell truth, honestly, transparently, that brings inner peace, self-confidence. Then self-confidence also you see, self-confidence with wisdom. Sometimes you see, blind self-confidence creates a lot of problems. Now these days, look, they are such a thing. The Syrian president, you see, seems, I think, somewhere also, I think, very sort of determined will. But that's actually blind. Unrealistic. And human history, we can see is that some of these leaders who create a lot of problems. This self-confidence there, but that self-confidence based on arrogance, self-centered arrogance, blind. So, see, when I say it's a self-confidence, you see, with common sense, with reasons, then with wisdom, with self-confidence, that's the really is one of the source of physical good health. And also, you see, the source of inner peace, mental peace. Now, peace, if we rely on religions, then those people who have not much interest in religion, then these may not serve us. So, if we rely on religion, then will not just cover these people who have not much interest for religion. Recently I saw one article, one report, I think 2 months ago, it mentioned that out of 7 billion human beings, about 1 billion non-believer. So then 6 billion supposed believer. But as I mentioned earlier, I'm a believer. Also, this is reality, not serious. A lot of believer, supposed as a believer, but not very serious, isn't it? So therefore, also there, because of that, we clearly mentioned is those people who have no sort of belief, no faith, that they got 1 billion. So quite a big number. So we must find a method to reach, you see, to reach out, to teach, right? These non-believers also. So we cannot rely on religious belief, but we should utilize human common sense, common experience, then scientific findings. So, I think through that way, we can educate these non-believers for your own interest for your own family, interest of for your own community. The moral principles is something very essential. Not thinking about next life, not thinking about heaven, not thinking about God, or not thinking about Buddha. This very existence of our life, everybody wants a happy life. The physical comfort, not sufficient.